Hi everybody and welcome to this EMA webinar on health research and innovation in the time of COVID. I'm George Valiotis. I'm the Executive Director of EMA. The rules of engagement are that we have muted your microphone, and that's just to make sure that we can hear clearly from everybody during the day. But if you do want to raise any questions, any chat, any questions about the presentation at any moment, you can type them into the chat. And at the end of the presentation, we'll come back to the questions and make sure that all your questions are being answered. These webinars are recorded and then we load them up onto a dedicated page on our website, which is also listed there. And we'll be live tweeting throughout the event, and you're welcome to do that as well. We use the hashtag EMA webinar. The agenda for today is the COVID-19 pandemic calls for responsible research and innovation agenda. So we're going to be hearing about that specifically through the eyes of a multi-act project and how that helps meet the challenge. And we're going to hear how that model so far has been used on multiple sclerosis and then how it can be applied to COVID as a result. So there'll be lots of take-home messages and opportunity to have a discussion with Paola Zaratin, who will be presenting with us today. So please welcome Paola. Hello, thanks for joining us, Paola.
Thank you, George, for having invited me and the MultiAct Consortium to contribute to this interesting webinar today.
Great. So I've just stopped my screen and I'll give you a chance to share yours.
Okay.
And everybody, while she just gets her screen ready, at the end of the webinar, I'm going to put up it's literally a 90-second poll to get your feedback. Your feedback really does shape these webinars. It's what's led to their better design and to the speakers that we have. So once she finishes presenting and we start chatting, we'd love to get your feedback. So I can see your screen is up and you're going to presentation mode. So I'll hand over to you, Paola.
Thank you so much. And good morning or good afternoon to everybody. It is really a pleasure for me today to have the opportunity to share and discuss with you some consideration about from one side about the impact that COVID pandemic is going to leave in the way we are funding, conducting and managing health research and care. And from the other side, to share the experience we are developing with the MultiAct projects. The MultiAct projects is a project that has received funding from the European Union under the Horizon 2020 and Responsible Research and Innovation Program. I'm the honor and the pleasure to coordinate the project as also Director of Scientific Research at the Italian MS Society. So let me start. Indeed, what I like to discuss with you today is, first of all, that the COVID pandemic call for responsible research innovation. Indeed, the COVID pandemic has unmasked existing need for responsible research innovation to shift from cross-cutting issues towards a strategic concern. And I'd like to share with you some consideration about this and discuss with you and get your feedback. I'm going to show you how MultiAct project can help meeting the challenge. And as George said, the project we are currently applied and focused the project on brain disorder and multiple sclerosis, but as you're going to realize, this is a framework and that I hope you will appreciate that can help for refining governance of health research and healthcare in many different sectors, and then take home messages. So let me start with the first consideration that I hope that you will share with me. Indeed, the COVID pandemic has unmasked the need for a mission-oriented model governance. And as we're describing this report from Mariana Mazzucato, and that has been then make it operative with the second version from 2018, And what the documents clearly highlight is that indeed the mission provides opportunity to increase impact of research and innovation at the European level, but I would say also internationally. And why focus on mission governance research will help us to increase impact. Indeed, the sustainability of health research and care will depend closely from our ability to develop multi-stakeholder and multidisciplinary organization, research and care initiative and organization. And indeed, this can only be achieved if stakeholders are focused on shared missions, and especially when the mission is transformational, and if the stakeholder and if the mission represent the explicit drivers of our initiative. And it's a fact that, as well described also in this other paper, the let's say the mission-driven governments have indeed fared better in the COVID pandemic situation versus the other country that have only the major goal as major goal efficiency and economic aspects. So this is the first consideration I wanted to share with you regarding COVID pandemic calls. The second one, and I think that is very, you know, clear to all of you, the second one is that indeed the coming pandemic call for health research and healthcare to form a unique ecosystem. Healthcare is the result of research, but is also indeed set the agenda of research, or should set the agenda of research. And in these days, we appreciate very much what does this mean, because it really is very important to design with the end in mind when we are doing research. And this is also well described and proposed in the European Council for Health Research position document published in 2018. And so therefore it's very important to, and again, also in this case, COVID-19 is just a mask, this need, but we knew already that to face a transformative mission and challenge like the COVID challenge, we have really to apply and to go and to work for health research and care unique ecosystem. So just to quote the case of Italy, that was indeed the first country that was hit by COVID pandemic and emergency. Indeed, we react immediately together with other stakeholders as the Italian Multiple Sclerosis Society to really put together a program to provide the answer and comprehensive answer to people with MS that are fragile subject in this condition. And for example, just to give you an example, one of the projects we develop under this program is a collection of clinical data to study, to evaluate the impact of COVID-19 on multiple sclerosis. And we have tons of data and information for research, but for us now the challenge is how we can ensure that impact of COVID research on society. How we can make sure that this data will really be uptake by the stakeholder to change the current and phase current situation, but also to avoid in the future that we will have other similar situation, or at least that we will be able to manage it properly. So, mission-oriented research and healthcare and health research unique ecosystem can be enabled or can be promoted by the European Community define responsible research innovation. And indeed, the thinking that underlies responsible research innovation is that we have to rethink about the concept of good science as such, challenge our notion of good science as such, because science is indeed when we are able to connect excellence, validity, and relevance by impacting on society values, and especially by engaging patient and society in research continuum as a key stakeholder with decision-making role. But what is the challenge? Why so difficult? Why we were not prepared? Why we are not at the point that responsible research innovation is a strategic concern? Because indeed it's very challenging to have relevant governance, relevant model, and tools to enable responsible research innovation. And here is where multi-act project comes. Again, this is European project, 3 years European project. And indeed, I like to stress the aspect that already this project is a multidisciplinary project. And I like to stress, by saying this, I like to stress the point that to impact on society is very important to go and foster multidisciplinary research and care. And in this consortium, you already have European organization focused on health, on digital technology, on healthcare, on co-accountability and management aspects, because to make it, you need really to put together, mix different discipline and stakeholders. And indeed, the project is a 3 years project. We have we are in the middle of the second year. And first of all, we wanted to understand what is around. We wanted to learn and build from. We didn't want to reinvent the wheel. So we want to make sure that our aim was and the model wasn't already there. And so the first year was a study and design here. And the second year that was about testing the model that we have developed into a specific test case study that is again a multiple sclerosis case study. And we are going to, during the third years, we are going to extend and expand this model to other brain disorder and hopefully also other healthcare research and health research and care sectors. So, but what multi-act want to develop or can offer to foster responsible research innovation? Indeed, what we have the ambitions to offer is tools to rephrase governance, to foster formal, responsible and research innovation governance. And in these slides, you can see the framework of MultiAct that essentially is based on, again, governance criteria that MultiAct has developed and that has to ensure collaborative efforts and co-accountability of all the stakeholders that are involved in a transformative mission. And the first thing that this initiative has to do is, again, be clear about the mission and be co-accountable for a given mission. Need to assure that stakeholders are relevant to this mission and are committed to this mission. And then more and more important, we need to understand whether, you know, what are the aspects of this mission that are of interest to the different stakeholders in order to make sure that we will able to maintain stakeholder engagement over time and able to produce an impact. And out of this co-accountability approach, and the again, the explicit driver is mission, and out of this co-accountability approach, we have developed and identify aspect and indicator under different dimension that will ensure that each stakeholder will see them represented in these different dimensions and will remain engaged over time. The model is being translated into digital toolbox that we hope will facilitate the initiative to use the framework and on guidelines. And the core aspect, of course, of this model, the core aspect of responsible research and innovation governance is that, as I said, patient and society are engaged in research and care. And specifically to this, to fulfill this goal, we have developed patient engagement guidelines. And the value for us of patient engagement guideline is that patients are engaged in the governance in order for us to meet the transformational mission and are engaged in the different step of research at the program and project level. And this, in our opinion, will enable the initiative to measure impact on outcomes that matter most to patients, of course, keeping this sustainable and increasing the value of patient engagement. So where we are currently testing the model in an initiative that is actually indeed the multiple sclerosis care unit initiative that aim to develop personalized care for multiple sclerosis. Also in this case, we went together with the stakeholder of this initiative through the multi-act framework using, of course, the tools that multi-act has developed. Means that we study carefully the mission, identify stakeholders that are relevant to this initiative, identify aspects that are relevant and represent a return of investment of the stakeholder involved in the initiative, and identify indicators that will help stakeholders to measure progresses of their agenda over time. The model is also under validation in other international multi-stakeholder initiatives, such as the Progressive Multiple Sclerosis Alliance initiative, that is another international initiative that has signed a partnership with MultiAct, as well as on responsible research innovation initiatives such as New Horizon initiative. So the model has attracted interest of the research community. We have published on Nature, Lancet Neurology and Current Opinion of Neurology, but just to say that for some different for different perspective, the model is of interest for the research community. Is of interest because we'll offer different way to measure impact of research in a more collective mission oriented manner. Is it of interest for to manage multi-stakeholder collaboration such as the one on focus on patient reported outcome development? And is it of interest to really make of patient reported outcome a indicator of impact of research on patients? So let me conclude with some take-home messages that is open, of course, for discussion. And really, I like to consolidate with you this take-home message. So the first one, and are this message are also based on a recent paper that have been published on Science that the title of this is indeed that we need to improve alignment of research policy and societal values. And the reason why it's so difficult, no matter, and we hope, I hope that we will learn, or we are learning from COVID pandemic, stakeholders still see responsible research innovation as a wish to have and not really a matter that need to be tackled in a serious manner and invest in a serious matter. So I think that the multi-act represent an opportunity, an important reference for to start structuring a model on a mission-oriented manner and collective sustainability manner. And indeed, I do believe that, I hope that COVID pandemic will really shift RRI from a cross-cutting issue to a strategic concern, and that other RRI project and initiative will help us really to turn research, health research and care into impact for our society that, as we are realizing, need to be a priority. And I hope that COVID-19 will give recognition of the role of organizations such as the one non-profit organization that indeed have in their DNA return of investment mainly focused on values that has an impact on society more than or together with the economic one. I'll stop here and I hope here that you have a question and we can discuss this topic together.
Terrific. Thanks, Paola, very much for that presentation. Now, as I've said in the chat, we'll be making that presentation available on our website so you can refer back to it and we'll add all the links. If you do have any questions, we've got some time now to answer them. And to get us started, you can type them into the chat box. And also while you do that, I'm actually going to put in a link to the evaluation. It takes 90 seconds and we do use that information to improve these. So please do that. Paola, my first question to you is, EMA's been a partner in the EU-funded project for about 4 years now. So we've got a really good understanding of this. But for people who are joining today, is this something you can easily step into? Or how do people even begin to take the steps towards this mission-centered partnership approach of a research agenda with patients? Where do you start?
Well, indeed, you start, usually as for any health research and care initiative, you have a promoter, you have someone that wake up in the morning and say, look, I want to go for this mission. I want to realize this, fulfill this mission, you know. But very often so far, and this is one of the barrier, you know, this promoter go ahead without caring about stakeholders. So the very important thing and MultiAct offer tools to enable this is to make sure that once you have a mission, you identify the stakeholder that are relevant for this given mission. And MultiAct offer a digital toolbox that will walk a stakeholder through the step that are needed to make sure that the relevant stakeholder are on board. Relevant stakeholder can express what are the aspects that they believe represent the return of investment for their organization and for the mission. And they can set indicator and agenda and indicator that will be used to manage and monitor progresses over time. Because this is very important. No one is going to be remain on board of an initiative if the mission does not represent its own return of investment. So we used to say that multi-act aspirational principle is act like an organization, but think like a movement.
Oh, that's nice. Okay, so there's two questions that have come through. One is on this theme. So I'll go to the first one from John Overtveit, and he asks, we in Sweden have found that the issue is implementation. Is there any research or iterative action research to implement and evaluate the findings of research?
Well, you know, this is one of the approach you can use because this multi-act is relevant to manage multi-stakeholder research initiative, but is also a useful tool to manage the research of a single organization when you want to make sure that your research is producing impact not only on excellence, so means impact factor, or you know, index, citation index, but also on patient, so on social dimension, or for example, economic dimension. So my advice is to really use this multi-act approach also for the when you have to fund research. And of course, you can have a database where in your database you are going to monitor not only impact factor but other indicators. I know that is challenging. I recognize that it's challenging because it's not into the system yet, this approach. And so we need to be responsible also at academic level and foster academia as stakeholder to take also this other indicator into consideration for career moving. And this is what a Nature letter we have published is discussing.
Okay, great. John goes on to ask a further question. Can we use any of this initiative to help prevent the tragedy of infection and deaths in long-term care homes that can reoccur in the winter?
Of course, I'm not sure we will be able. I mean, this is a good question, important question, odd question, but I'm not sure we will be able to prevent it in 2 months from now, because we need to work and to plan for this. And this model need to be uptake by our healthcare and the research system in order for us to be able to face emergency in the future. But if we are not going to implement this model, if we are not going to implement responsible and research innovation, we will never be able to face such a kind, to manage such a kind of emergency.
So then I might come back to the question from Sabri Ben Roman, who I think his question links to that, where he says, did MultiAct integrate the COVID experience into its framework? And if so, how?
This is a very interesting question. And actually, we are open to stakeholders that are also attending today's webinar to work with us to see how, you know, MultiAct framework can be tailored to the experience of COVID in health sector and see how it can be used in practice to really manage the emergency in the future if this is going to happen. What I can tell you is that the MS care unit, the multiple sclerosis care unit case study, indeed want to use a multi-act framework also to think about how the function of this unit need to change or need to be adapted in the case of emergency such as the COVID one.
Okay, so the other thing that's got me thinking about, Paola, is about the patient engagement. And like, I wonder if patient engagement as an action in of itself can feel really challenging to people. Like, I see two key messages here. One is about mission-centered governance and mission-centered research. But then I understand patient engagement to be a real critical component of this multi-act initiative. So how did people start with that? Does this all fit in together or do they begin somewhere different?
No, I mean, they have to start together. I mean, this is exactly the point and the selling point of patient engagement in MultiAct, if I can express myself in this way. Because the patient has to be considered as any other stakeholders. And because of this, of course, they will need some tools to be able to contribute with their experiential knowledge on the disease to the initiative. But we are not looking for a patient that are expert of science to be member of this initiative. We want really patient to come and be part of this initiative from the beginning by bringing their experiential knowledge on the disease. And differently from other initiatives where patients are trained in the, dependently from the mission, here again the mission is the explicit driver. You cannot engage patient just to engage patient, but you need to engage patients specifically on the priority of your mission or your agenda, that where they can really contribute or provide benefit to the initiative, because as any other stakeholder, they want to see the return of engagement in this initiative.
Great. Okay. If there are any other questions, we've still got some time to answer them. While we wait for that, I'll just remind you of the 90-second survey. If you haven't filled that out already, please do that. A few other things I'll tell you that if you're not already a member, please make sure you think about that. There's EMA is Europe's preeminent community of practice when it comes to health management, so please be part of what we're doing. And also MultiAct will be presenting at our conference in November, and if you haven't already registered, there's time to do that. And at our conference, MultiAct will be presenting a couple of papers that take further this conversation. Paola, did you want to say anything else about what you'll be presenting?
Actually I want to say that the EMA conference, we will present the outcome of co-creation process that we are developing with our case study, the Multiple Sclerosis Care Unit. Professor Comi, that is president of European Charcot Foundation and is also coordinating this initiative, will be presented at the meeting. So I welcome, I think that will be a nice way to see how we, MultiAct, can be turned into practice in a way can offer a framework to manage a multi-stakeholder research initiative in healthcare sector.
Terrific. Thanks so much for your time today, Paola. If people have any other questions, you can put them into the survey, and you can follow up on our website. I gave you information on where that'll be. And if you have any questions that you want that come to you later, then we can connect you to Paola and we can keep the conversation going. So thanks for joining us, Paola. Thank you so much, George, and thank you to all
people that have attended the webinar today. And I'm available to answer questions also on by email and to discuss on this topic.
Thanks everyone, take care, be well, and we'll see you soon.
Bye-bye, thank you.
Bye.